Yes, out of the three coordinates r, theta, and phi, about r we had a discussion. Now let we have the more insight about theta and phi. Means how in three-dimensional orientation of various orbitals can be explained. Previously our emphasis was towards only the radial coordinate. Now our emphasis will be the three-dimensional polar explanation for various orbitals. Let us see angular shapes of various orbitals. Students, our attempts are here to explain matter wave, to explain electron wave. That electron wave is represented by one function called as wave function psi. And in order to solve that wave function, in order to understand the wave function, we use one mathematical equation, which is that Schrödinger equation. And Schrödinger equation gives us idea about three quantum numbers. Shell number, that's the principal quantum number, subshell number, azimuthal quantum number, and orbital, that is a magnetic quantum number. Time being, I keep the modification of Schrödinger's equation aside because it's an intrinsic property of the electron. Let us understand the wave by means of Schrödinger equation. So quantum number is a one way by which we can understand the wave. We can understand the electrons. We can understand the electron waves, various shells, subshells, and orbitals. But pictorially, three-dimensional picture point of view, how do they look like? For that, we need to take help of spherical coordinates, polar coordinates. Which are those? Yes, R means radial coordinate, and doublet is there for angular coordinates. The doublet includes theta and phi. So r, theta, and phi can describe psi, can describe wave function. Or we need those values of r or theta and phi. Those can solve Schrödinger's equation. What will happen because of that? We will get clear-cut picture about orbitals. Radial coordinate and distribution with respect to it, that we have studied already. Now it is a time to study angular variation. So theta and phi, about which we will discuss. So in short, the wave function psi, which has, now I consider three quantum numbers, n, l, m, l, can be understood in spherical coordinates as radial wave function, which describes shell number and subshell number, principal quantum number and azimuthal quantum number. In addition to radial part, it encompasses angular part, which can describe subshell numbers and orbitals, azimuthal quantum number and magnetic quantum number. So to that angular part, we are giving weightage. In order to understand the angular part for various values of theta and phi, after substituting the suitable values for theta and phi, means which is the angular part, we get three-dimensional pictorial presentation for various orbitals. And orbitals are related to subshell, and subshell is related to shell. So clear-cut picture about various orbitals. Which orbitals so far we know? S orbital, px. See, p is a subshell, px is orbital, py, pz, dx square minus y square, dz square, dxy, dyz, dxz. So regarding those orbitals and their shapes, we are studying. Now in front of you, s orbital is represented. Any s orbital you can consider. It can be 1s orbital, 2s orbital, 3s orbital, any orbital. See how beautifully spherical it is. Here I am not representing atom, I am representing orbital. If you pay the proper attention,
inside the sphere there's a plus sign, positive sign. It is for what? Wave function. If we consider wave, then positive phase of the wave means 0 to pi, and negative phase of the wave, that is a more than pi to 360 or 2 pi. Out of that, positive wave is represented. Then you will be the question, will not the negative wave? Yes, any wave we can consider, but throughout the sphere, throughout the s orbital, only one phase will be there, either positive or negative. So that s orbital, s representation means what is the value of azimuthal quantum number small l? Yes, that small l is equal to 0. How many possibilities of magnetic quantum numbers will be there? Yes, we know the basic magnetic quantum number takes the values from plus l to minus l, means plus 0 to minus 0, means only 0. Therefore, there is only one orbital, only one s orbital, and that is represented here. It's the same and wave function distribution. I hope the s orbital is clear to you. Let us study now the next p subshell. P represents azimuthal quantum number and its value small l is equal to 1. Then magnetic quantum number will take values from plus 1 to minus 1, means plus 1, 0, minus 1, 3 values. Therefore, we consider 3 p orbitals will be there. Orbitals means magnetic quantum number. Means ml is equal to plus 1, ml is equal to 0, and ml is equal to minus 1. These 3 possibilities are there. Let us see the first possibility for l is equal to 1, ml is equal to plus 1. Conventionally, it is not as a thumb rule. We consider it as what? Px orbital. See that orbital. It is dumbbell in shape. Two lobes are there. Between two lobes, there is a gap, or only one nodal point is there. Why am I saying nodal point? There is a change in wave function, or one nodal plane, you can understand. Right side, if I consider positive lobe, left side will be negative lobe. How that sine distribution occurs? Let us consider right side positive. While moving from that positive lobe to negative lobe by any angle, means from positive lobe, then z axis, then negative direction of y axis, there's a gap. In between gap comes, vacuum comes. If vacuum comes, means there are no electrons. So in such cases, phase changes, wave function changes, positive becomes negative. So opposite lobe is represented by negative sign. Again, it is not a rule that right side means positive, left side is negative. Suppose we consider right lobe as a negative, then left lobe will be positive. This orbital is along x-axis. Therefore, we say it is px orbital. Similarly, if ml is equal to 0, then we represent this orbital as pz orbital. Why? Because that orbital is along z-axis. Shape is same, dumbbell shape. One of the lobe will be positive, other lobe will be negative. Now see the third p orbital which is possible. ML value will be now minus 1. It is along y-axis. Therefore, we say it is a py orbital. One lobe is positive, other lobe is negative. I hope the p subshell and 3 possible orbitals px, py and pz are clear to you. Let us see one more subshell, that is d subshell. D subshell means what is the value of small l? It is 2. If l is equal to 2, then what are the possible values for ml? Plus 2 to minus 2. Plus 2, plus 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2. Total 5 values are there. Let us see what are the shapes of those orbitals. The first possibility, l is equal to 2 means d subshell. ml is equal to plus 2. It represents dx square minus y square orbital. See its orientation. These d orbitals are made up of two dumbbell shaped orbitals. This x square minus y square orbital is along x axis and y axis. So one lobe is along positive direction of x axis, opposite lobe will be along negative direction. One lobe along positive direction of y axis, opposite lobe along negative direction of y axis. So So angle between each lobe is 90 degree. So this orbital is in xy plane. Now see the wave function. If I consider right side lobe along x-axis is positive. While moving from that lobe to the other lobe, nearest lobe, I'll find gap. So positive direction of y-axis, their sign of the wave function is negative. Why? In between gap came, vacuum came. If vacuum comes during our journey, then sign changes. Angular journey we are doing. From positive direction of y-axis to negative direction of x-axis, if I am moving, same thing will happen. In between gap will come. Gap comes, sign will change. Sign will alter. Negative sign becomes positive. Again, from negative direction of x-axis, if I move to negative direction of y-axis, gap will come. Sign will change. Sign of whom? Wave phase. That's a wave function. So positive will become negative. So if you read that wave phase distribution, opposite lobes are with same wave function. So there is one kind of center of symmetry. Centrosymmetry is there. Now come to next d orbital. D orbital means L is equal to 2. ML now will be plus 1. It represents dxz orbital. Dxz orbital, see the lobes. The lobes are not along x and z axis. Those are in between x and z axis. And it is in xz plane. Lobes are between axes which are represented and in xz plane. So name of that orbital is xz, dxz. Again, lobes. If right side up lobe positive, left side up lobe negative. Left side down lobe positive, right side down lobe negative. So alternate signs are there. But opposite lobes are with same wave function, same wave phase. Now see the third possible orbital where ML is equal to 0. It is dz square orbital. Lobes are majoritically along z axis. But little portion is there in the form of ring, as like ring remains around a satellite or planet Saturn. Likewise in XY plane, there is one ring. And that ring, that cloud has only one wave function, that's a negative. If you see the upper lobe, positive. While angular journey, that ring will come. So sign of ring is negative. Wave function of ring is negative. From that negative ring, if I come to down portion of z-axis, I have to change the sign of plus. So here also, centrosymmetricity is there. It's a dz square orbital. Now see fourth possible d orbital where ML is equal to plus 1. It is dyz orbital. The lobes are in between y and z axis and this orbital is in yz plane. Again, as I discussed before, four lobes are there. Angularly when we are moving, sign will alter plus minus in such a way opposite lobes are with same wave function. Here also centrosymmetricity is there. Now see the last orbital where ML is equal to minus 2. It is dxy orbital, means lobes will be in between or along in between x and y axis, and this orbital is in xy plane. Wave function distribution plus minus in such a way opposite lobes are with same wave function. Here also centrosymmetricity is there. These are the 5D orbitals we have represented. So in all what we discuss in this video, angular representation, angular shape of S orbital, PX, PY, pz orbitals, dx square minus y square, dxz, dz square, dyz, dxy.
Yes, student, as a homework question for you, we have studied three subshells S, P and D and respective orbitals. What do you think? Orbitals of which subshells are centrosymmetric? Now, you have to find what is meant by centrosymmetricity. Shapes are there with you. Wave function distribution is there with you. Now let us see how many of you give the correct answer. I am waiting for your reply.
Yes, now with these basic aspects of quantum approach,
we need to go to apply our quantum approach. Hydrogen and hydrogen-like species means one electron species, somewhat we discuss as per the Bohr's model. But our elements are with many electrons. How can we explain many electron systems? So in order to explain many electron systems, a few concepts we need to study. Concepts like penetration, shielding, effective nuclear charge, we are going to discuss.